All right, Coach, it's the NFL on EA Sports as you take a look there at Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. The scene in South Philly a few moments ago. Boy, the city of brotherly love is fired up. They're saying fly, Eagles, fly as they get ready to match up with the Minnesota Vikings. Cousins and the Vikings with a first and 10. And it's a welcome back to health for last year's number one pick. This is Dalvin Cook. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30.
That's a good shot. That's a good shot.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
Now a first carry for Latavius Murray. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 34-yard line. Give him four on the carry, and it'll make this a third and about two.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a game, considering the blitz that they just had against them.
An early test, two plays in. This is third and two. They'll run it. Here's Cook. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves to James. Defense had a chance to get off the field here on the opening drive, couldn't do it.
I know that we go into these meetings with coaches, and sometimes maybe we can get, you know, a little bit numb because they're always going to talk about how important third down is, aren't they? Offense and defense. In this case, one capitalized, and the other, as you said, had a chance to get off the field and didn't get it done.
They run again on first down. Cook. Oh, he faked it with a juke. Now he's got some room. The 20. And he's taken down deep in Philadelphia territory. A big play there out of Cook. 45 yards on the ground. Couple of nice carries back to back here, establishing the ground game a bit.
Yeah, these aren't bare bones runs now. I mean, they're getting substantial yardage, the kind of yards you're looking for, right? Let's go ahead and use a cliche. Stay ahead of the change, right? Five or more yards each time. That's what you're looking for, setting the tone and getting your offensive line going.
Good sign on the open ground. They'll get it up the middle. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal. Nothing on first down, so the ball remains at the 8-yard line, second and goal. They'll give it to him up the middle. And they'll get him down here about the 5-yard line. They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's third and goal. Driven it down the field nicely here on the opening drive, but now it's put up or shut up.
No doubt about it, because to make that type of a drive and ultimately kick a field goal would feel very disappointing. But I'm just wondering, is the head coach thinking, is this four down territory? Might he go for it?
Third and goal for Cousins. And he will score. Touchdown, Vikings. Adam Thielen, a 5-yard touchdown. And the Vikings take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. Well, that's how they envisioned it, get the football to start the game and score it.
And I don't know if that was scripted, was it an audible, or was it just a play call that they had in their pocket? No matter what, they had the right call on against the right defense, and they end up in the end zone.
Extra point up and good by Bailey, and it's now a 7-0 game. Bailey now to kick this one away. This is taken at the 3. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field.
Yeah.
Brents and the Eagles now with a first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. Throwing now is Wentz. And complete to Zach Ertz. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. That's a good way to start the drive. 17 yards and a first down.
I do believe we'll see a little bit more of this as this game progresses, because when you can have that type of a game in the middle of the defense,
it hurts them now.
In so many ways, because most teams like to be strong down the middle. And if you can sting them there, that opens things up for you on the outside as well.
That's where either big tight end is so good, that middle third, the seam routes, the end routes. Yeah, you're right.
You see more of it. Yeah, it takes a lot of courage and fortitude to get in the middle as well. And he's got it.
They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains. These guys hooking up right away here, Charles. Two plays, both passes in his direction, and both catches.
And in our time together, have we not seen the tight end position continue to develop in the passing game? You know, at some point, we may not call them tight ends anymore. We may have to come up with an entirely different way of designating that position and what they do on the field. Because when I hear tight end, I think of the old school, hand in the dirt, blocking on the line of scrimmage. These guys are much more receiver than they are guys who are going to move in the passing, in the running game. Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
This is Darren Sproles. Works his way inside the 30 on a pickup of four. Back live with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. It's the Eagles with the ball here to begin quarter number two. And they're driving, but they come up on a third and short here.
Four down. Here we go.
They run with a giant. And he's able to get the first here as he's taken down at the 25. It's a gain of four there that gives him a new set of downs.
I know the game's changed. A lot of people would say it's evolved. Look, I'm a little bit Neanderthal, okay? I love this. No exotic formations, no misdirection. Just line up and run the darn ball, pick up the first down. I love it.
Yeah, third and short. That's what you're supposed to do, like you said. Old school. Smash mouth football. Now a play fake here on first down. Nelson Agholor, the intended receiver. And now it's second down.
Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want, get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
Line of scrimmage, again the 25, second and 10.
Alert, three
out. Now a play fake, Wentz. And this is Ertz with it, right side.
Oh, yeah.
And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. That catch good for five. It's third down.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
From the gun on third down, wins. And he's going to go down. Back at the 27-yard line, he's sacked. Emerson Griffin. He's the one that gets him down. It'll be a loss of five, and it'll bring up fourth down.
Sack City, baby.
Now to try the Eagle field goal, Jake Elliott. Right hash mark, a 42-yard attempt. And the kick by Elliott is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So, yes, it's only three, but at least they're able to answer back after giving up the touchdown to start the game.
Yeah, I like the observation there, because getting some points on the board, very positive for them. Feel a little bit better about things, because if you don't score, you potentially have opened the door for them to score again, and then you're down 14.
After the field goal, here's Elliott to kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll wind up getting an extra. extra couple yards here for his trouble as he'll bring this one out to the 27. As Minnesota comes back out of the field, let's take a peek, Charles, at what they've done so far this year. 1-2-1, a tough week 5 matchup at Philly. Yeah, this was a team that many thought could be the best in the league. Not the start that their fans envisioned.
Yeah, not the start, but their fans may want to reflect back to last season. This team started 2-2 and then won 8 in a row and 11 of 12 on the road to the NFC Championship game. So maybe just a little bit of patience with them now. The deal for Kirk Cousins in the offseason, I think, is paying great dividends, even though the record doesn't show it. 10 touchdowns against only 2 interceptions. I thought he was marvelous last Thursday night against the Los Angeles Rams. Matched Jared Goff essentially throw for throw. He was terrific. Their defense, the asterisk that's supposed to carry them, that's what they have to show up right now. And their head coach, Mike Zimmer, says, we're going to get that done.
Second down, Cousins. Incomplete. Right side, the tight end, Rudolph. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now gives him a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
You got four.
DeHunt! On Andy!
DeHunt! Third and short yardage. Cousins. Open man is Thielen. It's complete. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. A first down for Minnesota. Cousins finding Thielen.
Hey, we talked about Adam Thielen a little bit last year, didn't we? Possession receiver, makes some tough catches, gets it done, and he's a homeboy. Grew up very close to the Twin Cities.
And showing those possession receiver skills right there to pick up the first. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Cousins now to throw on first down. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it, or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it, no one got it. So line of scrimmage, still with 39 on second and 10.
DeHunt!
A second down throw for Cousins. His throw incomplete. Nigel Bradham, the linebacker, right there on the coverage.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here because they didn't completions on first and second down. Now you got to worry a little bit about the clock because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. But if you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
The Vikings on third down. A perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. This is third and 10. Cousins again. Shy of midfield at the 48. Well, the Eagles going to signal for a timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Now to kick it away is the punter, Matt Wyatt. Back deep is Darren Sproles. And that'll hit in the end zone. Much too much leg there. That'll be a touchback. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And last time able to get 3. It's not what they wanted. They wanted 6, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just, I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end.
They're going to be going for 6. Now wins. And Matthews hit the middle with a grab. And they'll bring it down at pick up on the pitch and catch. On play action, wins. The Vikings after it, and they get there for the sack. The Vikings going to signal for the first of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. It's a Johnny, and he's going to lose yardage here. Back to his own 18. And another timeout called by the Vikings now, as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Now on fourth down, it's Cameron Johnston on to punt it away. Marcus Sherrill's back deep for Minnesota. Fielded just inside the 20. They'll call that a punt of 59 yards. Tough to do better than that. And the Vikings will take over here, first and 10. The Vikings offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. They got the lead last time, had to punt it though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage. Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide him. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
On first and 10, Cousins. And Woods has it, the tight end. Given 9 there on the first down completion.
Seeing that play and understanding just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice gain right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
Cousins now on second down. And that will be incomplete with a clock showing 18 seconds now to go. The Vikings on third down. They've been good, 3 for 4 thus far. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation. He'll run here. It's Murray. And he got blown up. Losing yardage on the play back at the 44. And the Eagles are going to go ahead and take another timeout, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. Here's Matt Weil now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. this one hits at the one, continues on into the end zone for a touchback. The Eagles offense now, they head back on the field. And you got to think, if this is anything other than just taking a knee, I'd be very surprised.
Yeah, they've got enough to talk about at the half. Why do anything else? Just get out of there.
Likely time for one final snap as they start out first and 10. They'll start out on the ground with a giant. And he'll be taken down here at about the 23-yard line. So we've reached halftime here in a four-point game. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. This is Fielded at the goal line. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Out come the Eagles now as they'll go on offense first here in the third quarter. They're close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess that in the locker room, they talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. They'll begin the drive with a giant. Take it forward for about five up to the 28-yard line.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
Continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
Here we go. Back, ladies.
Now they'll throw it. Wins. And he'll dump it underneath to his running back. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. It'll go as a gain of six that time, and it moves the chains as well.
Assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
Everyone's got four.
Here we go. Back, man.
They stay on the ground. Again, it's Ajayi. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other three here on third down?
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again. Go play action and hit them over the top.
The Eagles on third down. Just one for three thus far. Here it's third and three.
Here we go.
Back. Working from the gun. Wentz. Well, they would have gotten the conversion if he could hold on. Instead, the drop means it'll be fourth down. Fair to say, hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better, got to get more help. Obviously, one that should have been caught. They got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
Now this is going to carry well into the end zone for a touchback. It's the Vikings' turn on offense. We get ready for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
Hey, how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude.
To get a little more cushion. Now Cousins, looking sideline, incomplete. Stephon Diggs, his intended receiver. That'll bring up second down.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
After the incompletion, they'll try once more from the 20-yard line on second and 10.
Jahan, 180! Jahan, Hunt!
On second down, Cook. And he'll find some space up to about the 25. Malcolm Jenkins up to make the stop.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get them into a manageable third down because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
There and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
Here's Matt Wild now as he's on to punt for Philadelphia. Sproles the return. Give him 11 yards that time on the return. And the Eagles will have it, taking over a first and 10. The Eagles coming out as they get ready. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their drive.
There's a handoff to Ajayi to begin the drive. Ajayi's going to go. 20. Touchdown. Ajayi. 71 yards. And the Eagles are able to cash it in for six. Increased his production in this game, and now he's over 100 yards.
And break out your calculator, partner, because his yards per carry went up significantly.
Skyrocketing.
Big time jaunt all the way to the end zone.
Elliott good on the extra point, and the lead is now 10-7. Elliott now to kick this one away. To return, here comes Marcus Sherrills. He'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. And out now come the Vikings. And right now these guys, they're shuffling a little bit, maybe doubting, because three straight drives have ended with him punting the football away.
Yeah, so you start pointing fingers at each other a little bit, asking a lot of questions. What are you seeing? What are you getting? Maybe trying to narrow down your playbook a little bit and maybe get simpler rather than more complex in order to try and fashion together a drive.
First down throw for Cousins. He's got the connection over the middle to Diggs. And he's able to get up here to the 26. That throw good for four. It's second down.
Yeah, baby. Yeah, baby.
Four yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and six.
You got four.
The hard. Andy.
Again, this is Cook. It's a loss of four. Now third down.
Well, forget about finding a lane there. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. Probably fortunate he was able to hold on to the football.
Big play coming up. Here's 3rd and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. Drops off as they look to throw. And he's able to find Diggs. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. And that goes for a gain of 31.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that and have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive the team towards a victory.
First down, here's Cousins. And Rudolph has it left side. And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up 2nd down.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target,
guy you can spot
pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
2nd and 5 after the 5-yard completion on 1st down.
Jahan, 180!
From the gun, here's Cousins. He's got it complete to Diggs right side. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. A Vikings 1st down, Diggs able to find his way free and get the catch from Cousins.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at it, and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out to the sideline and make a catch.
Cousins on 1st down. And it cuts free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up 2nd down.
Anytime a defense can sit back in a zone like that, it tends to create a lot of congestion in the middle of the field. Makes it very hard to slot one in.
Looked like I-4 at rush hour in your hometown of Orlando, Florida. An absolute mess. Under 4 to go now as they come up on 2nd down. Throwing again, Cousins on 2nd and 10. And this is going to be incomplete.
Everything about that play tells you about today's NFL offenses and what they're asking out of running backs. You can't just be a guy who can run the football. You have to be able to catch it as well. And he didn't get that done on that play.
Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is 3rd and long.
Jahan, 180! Hey, Jahan, hut!
They'll throw again. Cousins. But he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. We have not seen a whole lot of wide open receivers. Everything seemingly has been contested.
And that's another nice job there to force an incompletion. They've been very cohesive, knowing each other's moves all game long, and they've been on the spot just about every time.
And they've held them in check on the scoreboard.
Everything looked okay. He just never got the ball on target. And knowing him, he'll be disappointed with that effort.
Brents and the Eagles now with a 1st and 10 at their own 44.
Here, here we go.
Waiting!
Sean Jeffrey, the intended receiver, and it's 2nd down.
Nice play there to force the incompletion, and to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunch.
Once again here on 2nd and 10. He was trying to get it to Zach Ertz that time, and it's 3rd down. First quarter, Charles, you really emphasized the importance of winning the turnover battle as a visiting team, as an underdog. They haven't forced a single turnover in this game.
And right now they're losing, so no turnovers might lead to no victory.
Another incompletion would certainly be ideal defensively. A big play now. This is third and 10. From the gun, it's Wentz. Hurts over the middle. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down. I hate to surrender the football when you're nursing a slim lead, but they're going to have to punt it away. Trust that defense.
It's the right play at this stage of the game as well. You don't need to press it here because you do have that little bit of a cushion, and you count on your D to make it stand up.
Now the Vikings offense gets set to take over here. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, come get a little bit closer this time. I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
Really nice play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball, but for the guys on the offensive line, they're doing a nice job of trying to protect their passer. But when a guy hops in the air and goes airborne to try and knock one away, it's difficult because you can't reach out and grab him. That'll be a holding penalty. So all you're trying to do is make some type of a play on it, make some type of contact to try and get his arms out of the sky.
So the long attempt falls innocently to the ground, and it brings up third.
Trying to erase that deficit all at once. One big shot. He took it. Unfortunately for him, incomplete.
All right, possibly here we go. A turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. From the shotgun, it's Cousins. And that's incomplete. Pretty quick with his fingers to start and stop after the ball hit the ground. I'm giving him some credit.
No, I'm thinking about the mental focus, you know? My mental focus.
Yeah, that's true.
Gotta stay with it.
That's true. Here's Matt Wild now. He's been terrific so far. Now Sproles. So a change of possession here on the punt. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The Eagles offense back out onto the field. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
We got four. There we go. Here we go.
They'll run it here. And he'll get this one up to about the 39 here.
We got three.
Give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
I like a guy who understands the situation. I also like a guy who you look at him and you say, that looks like a guy who knows the coach is going to say, guess what? You drop this one, you'll be carrying around the training facility for an entire week.
Maybe flashback to high school or college, carrying it around campus, right?
The old gauntlet drill, right? Anyone get the ball out while he's sitting in class and bring it back to the coach? He's in big.
And down he goes. They bring down Wentz on the sack. Danielle Hunter in there to take him down and to take us to the 2-minute warning. Eagles coming up here on a third and long, so Wentz and company with some work to do after the sack.
Four down.
180. And he'll go on the ground. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. And now we'll see a timeout used on defense as they stop it right out of the break with 1:57 to go in the ballgame. The Eagles send out their punter now as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. As a 53-yard punt. And the Vikings will be backed up deep to begin their drive as they take over first and 10. The Vikings now heading onto the field. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. You might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 15. That throw good for four. It's second down. He'll lift to throw. It's complete to Laquon Treadwell. And they'll get him down here at the 23. Cousins able to connect with Treadwell for a Minnesota first.
It's a hot.
Back to throw. What's the point by Diggs? And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. A really good pickup of 28 yards. Inside the 40. 10 more there and another first down. First down now, but that clock rolling. Back to throw. He's going to let it fly. And this is caught. Touchdown. And they've taken the lead here in the final minute.
Wow. I know it's a never say never situation, but to me, that looks like that's the one that's going to finish them off.
The score that puts them in front here late, but now you got to rally your kick team, don't you, and say the last thing we need is a big return.
And what happens is guys get overeager, get out of their lane because they're so excited they want to make the last tackle. You mess up, could come back at you a long way.
Bailey got the extra point, and the lead is now 14-10. Bailey now to kick this one away. This will be taken in at the one. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21-yard line. Now Philadelphia ready to get going on offense again. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trite expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a 2nd and 3, 2nd and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. Don't want to get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage.
Trying to the middle, and it's incomplete. He's unable to complete it there, and just not the game that you would expect from him. He's been off the mark really start to finish.
Yeah, it makes you wonder what exactly is going on. Is he a little bit dinged up here, or is it just off just by a bit? Maybe he can get it back in this situation. He'll need to.
From the 21, it's 2nd and 10.
Here we go.
They'll look to throw. And he comes back with one complete. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. Yeah. And before they can run this third down play, we're going to get a timeout. As the clock will stop with 45 seconds left to go in the game. The Eagles on third down. They've had their troubles. Just 1 for 6. This is 3rd and 4.
There we go. Back.
To throw his wins. And this is going to be incomplete. There to knock that one away defensively, Eric Kendricks. This defense so strong all afternoon long. Well executed again there.
This is a group that really functions well off of each other. No matter what the assignment, the other person fills in the exact proper spot. They've made it very, very hard for them to find open places to throw the football.
20!
Now Wentz, gotta have this one. And that is incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And that'll be just about all she wrote for this one. So now let's reset here, Charles. They do have two timeouts left, so they can stop the clock twice. This one's not quite over yet.
No, and what you're doing on defense, you got to use both timeouts, obviously. But you've got to call defenses are going to force the issue early, meaning you want that play over fast. Hey, you don't want to give them time to dance around in the backfield or run a wide sweep that'll take off time. Blitz them, put pressure on them, make sure that play ends quickly so that you can go ahead and keep moving.
Now the Minnesota offense set to take over again. They have the lead, still a one-possession game, but the defense got to stop. They've got the football now, just salted away, right?
Exactly. That's all the defense is counting on from their offense. They did their job in a big way. You know they're over on the sidelines now starting to take their tape off and, hey, we've done this thing. The offense has to put it away, and that means ball security.
Absolutely. Stranger things have happened. Victory formation time for the Vikings as they'll take a knee here. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense. As the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play. The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is third and long.
Four down.
Behind, what is he?
Cousins is going to take this one down to a knee and end it.
I don't know about you, partner, but watching them take the knee there and finish this one off, I feel like I'm going to be sore tomorrow. This was one bruising affair, low scoring, but my kind of football.
Not a work of art. But maybe in your world, a little bit of a work of art. You like the defensive side.
I thought it was pretty. I can't help myself. I thought it was pretty.
And it ends in a kneel down as the clock rolls down to zeros. A road win in the National Football League. Charles, you never take that for granted, no matter who you're playing, no matter where you're playing.
You take it and you run with it. And you know you prime the pump all week in your own home facility. No one thinks we can do this. Only people who believe are right here in this room. And then you go on the road, band together, and get it done.
So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaughan. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. With that, we say so long from Philly.